Hello everyone, my name is Ramchandra Reddy. You are watching Chemistry YouTuber. Today again, I brought from a topic, shortcut to find out the hybridization. How to find out the hybridization of a molecule by using the formula. Normally, I am not teaching here the concept of hybridization. I will tell you a simple trick or formula. Based on the formula, we can find out the hybridization. So the formula is, H is equal to V plus M minus C plus A by 2. Here V is nothing but group number of central atoms. M is number of monovalent atoms, like which are having one bond. Hydrogen, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, monovalent atoms. And C is charge on cation, plus 1, plus 2, charge will be there. That means charge we are taking. Plus 1 means 1, plus 2, 2. Charge on anion is A. Here we have to remember without sign we have to take. Suppose minus 1, if it is there, we have to take plus 1. Minus 2 charge means take 2. Minus 3 charge means take 3. Don't take the sign, take the number. After substituting all these values into this, we get one number. That number, if I get H value 2, if I get it is sp hybridization. 3 sp2 hybridization. 4 sp3. 5 sp3d. 6 sp3d2. 7 sp3d. Okay, this is the formula, simple formula. Without the concept of hybridization also, we can find out the a molecule, given molecule, what is the hybridization based on the formula. Let us see some examples. I will take ammonia and SO2. Okay, ammonia. Here we have to remember that V nothing but what? Group number of central atom. Central atom means, you all of you know, central atom some elements I write here. Boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine. Boron third group, carbon fourth group, nitrogen fifth group, oxygen sixth group, fluorine seventh. Boron aluminium, carbon silicon, nitrogen phosphorus, oxygen sulfur, chlorine, fluorine, bromine, iron. This you remember, you can find out the hybridization. Okay, coming to the point, I write here H is equal to V plus M minus C plus A by 2. Okay, we find this later. First, let us see this. V, central metal atom. What is central metal atom here? Nitrogen. What is the group number of nitrogen? 5 plus. M is number of monovalent atoms like hydrogen, chlorine, and here we can say hydrogens are monovalent. How many are there? 3. 3. Can you say charge on this? Either cation charge, plus charge, or minus charge? No. So I can take 0, 0. 5 plus 3, 8 by 2, 8 by 2 means what? 4. 4 means which hybridization? Yes, P. Okay. So this way we can find out the hybridization for any molecule. Now we'll see some example. We'll cover here maximum molecules of hybridizations. Okay, I write some charge molecule AlCl4 minus NO2 plus NO3 minus. You see these examples. H is equal to central atom is what? Aluminium. Aluminium group number 3. 3 plus how many monovalent atoms are there? 4. Can you see any charge on cation? Is it cation? No, it is anion. Charge of cation 0, anion charge 1. You remember it is charge is minus 1. I am taking as 1. This is the formula V plus M minus C plus A by 2. In this formula, A is charge on anion. A, it is actually charge on is minus 1, but I am taking 1. I already told you, take the anion charge without sign. Okay, number you take. So that we get 8 by 2 is equal to 4. 4 means what? SP3 hybridization. Okay, NO2 plus. So what is central atom is what? Nitrogen. Group number 5. Monovalent atoms, is there any monovalent atoms in this? Like hydrogen, chlorine, bromine, and no, 0. Charge on cation, 1. You can see plus, plus means plus 1. Charge on anion, 0. By 2 is equal to 2. Is that 5 minus 1 by 2? So this is sp hybridization. Okay, if you take NO3 minus, NO3 minus H is equal to, central atom is nitrogen, group number 5. Monovalent atom 0, charge on cation 0, charge on anion is what? 1. Don't take minus 1, take 1. By 2 is equal to 3. 3 means what? Sp2. So some of the molecules which are actually 18 group elements, you can see HCF2, HCF4, HCF6, HCO3, HCOF4 and HCO2F2. You can see these examples. HCF2, central atom is what? Xenon. Xenon group name is what? These are inert gases, 18 group elements, 8th group. I can write here, 8th group elements are what? Helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, red. Xenon has what? 8th group. So I can write here, 8+. How many monovalent atoms are here? Fluorine is a monovalent. How many are there? 2. Can you see any charge on this? No positive, no negative charge. Divide by 2. Is equal to 5. 5 is what? sp3 dehydration. Got it? Next here, 8+, how many monovalent atoms are there? 4. There is no charge on this molecule, no positive, no negative. By 2, 6. 6 means sp3 dehydration. HCF6, you can write here 8+6 by 2, 7. 7 means sp3 d3. XeO3 xenon, central metal atom, 8. Is there any monovalent atoms in this? No monovalent atoms. So 0. Can you see any charge on this? No. So simply 8 plus 0 minus 0, everything is 0. By is equal to 4. 4 means what? sp3 hydrogen. Okay. And XeOF4 molecule also you can see. 8 plus, how many monovalent atoms are there? 4. Can you see any charge on this? No. 6. 6 means what? sp3. And what about HCO2F2? How to find HCO2F2? 8 plus monovalent atoms are 2 by 2 is equal to 5 sp3 d. Right? So this way we can find out the hybridization of any inorganic species mainly. I am talking about only inorganic species. I am not talking about the carbon containing compounds. Carbon containing compounds is different, I will explain now again that. Here, you can take any inorganic of SO2, SO3, HCF2, HCF4, SF4, SF6, IF7. So whatever the molecules are there, for all those compounds, we can find out the hybridization based on the simple formula. V plus M minus C plus A by 2. But remember one point here, A means charge on anion without site. Understood? Now, I will tell you hybridization. Not only we can find out the hybridization based on this formula, but some molecules we have observed like heteroatoms like oxygen, nitrogen. Okay. I let for example. So have you observed this? Hybridization in carbon compounds. Carbon compounds, how to find the hybrid carbon compounds? We all of you know carbon if it contains 4 side single bonds, that is sp3. If carbon contains double bonds, that carbon is sp2. If carbon contains both sides double bonds also, for double bonds there is sp. Triple bond means sp. Okay. The carbon contains 4 sides single bonds sp3. If it contains double bonds sp2, both sides double bond like carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide. This contains sp hybridization. Only one side triple bond like acetylene, ethylene, propylene, and all these are sp hybridization. And in all these molecules, I'll write an example. CH3, CH, double bond CH, C double bond CH. You see this molecule. What is the hybridization of this carbon? All are single bonds. There is no double bonds and triple bonds in this. sp3. What about this? It has one double bond. sp2. What about this carbon? It has one double bond. sp2. And this carbon has triple bond. So this is sp. And this carbon is sp. Okay? So this way you can find out the hybridization of any carbon. Can you tell me what is the hybridization of this molecule? What is the hybridization of this carbon? This carbon having double bonds. Yes or no? So this is sp2. All carbons are same. All carbons are having double bond. So all are same sp2 hybridization. And what about this? This is single bonds sp3. This is single bonds sp3. Okay. So this way we can find out the hybridization carbon containing compound. This does not require any formula. Based on the double bonds and triple bonds, we can find out the hybridization. And one more point: what is the hybridization of the this oxygen? This oxygen. What is the hybridization of the this nitrogen? If you want to identify hybridization of this oxygen, hybridization of this nitrogen, again I will tell you a simple trick for this: how to find out the hybridization of the heteroatoms. For the heteroatoms, you apply the simple formula. First, let's take an example. See, this is the one. We have to find out hybridization for all the atoms, not only carbons, but also for oxygen, nitrogen, everything we have to find. Here the point is number of sigma bonds plus free lone pair. Free lone pair. Number of sigma bonds plus free lone pair. This sum of these numbers, if you get 2, sp, 3, sp, 2. 4, sp3 and so on. Like this will find. Okay, see, I will take this carbon. This carbon thing about what? CH3. These are having how many sigma bonds here? Anyway, single bonds. All are single bonds. This is sp3. This carbon having double bond, sp2. What about the hybridization of this oxygen? This oxygen. You see, sigma bonds plus 3 lone pair. Sum of the number we have to find out here. Oxygen, how many lone pairs are there? 2 lone pairs. How many sigma bond pi is oxygen? It has a 2 bonds, 1 sigma 1 pi. Don't take the 2 bonds, 1 bond we have to take because this sigma, it is a pi. So 2 plus 1, 3. 3 means what is the hybridization? sp2. So this is sp2 hybridization. Understood? What about this nitrogen? If you observe this nitrogen, hybridization of this nitrogen. Sigma bonds plus 3 lone pair. How many sigma bonds for this? 1, 2, it has 1 bond with hydrogen. So 3 sigma bonds plus free lone pair. Is these lone pairs are free? Actually, it has a lone pair. Nitrogen has a lone pair of electrons. But this lone pair of electrons involves in resonance. So, if this lone pair of electrons involves in resonance, we cannot call it as a free lone pair. That is a conjugation. So we have to take only 3 sigma bonds, lone pairs 0 is equal to 3. 3 means what? Which type of hybridization? That is sp2. Right? And what about this? This carbon is sp3. This carbon also is sp3. This carbon also is sp3. What about this oxygen? This oxygen. This oxygen, see, it has 2 sigma bonds. It is 1 sigma, it is 1 sigma. How many lone pairs are there? 2. Is this lone pair involved in resonance? No, there is no resonance. So we can take 2 sigma bonds, 2 lone pair. 2 sigma, 2 lone pair is equal to 4. 4 means what is the hybridization? sp3. This I can write sp3. Okay. So what is the hybridization of this carbon? This is CH3. Say this is sp3. This is sp3. This is all are sp3 in this case. Okay. So this is sp3. This is sp. What about this? This carbon has a double bond. Double bond means what? Sp2. This carbon also double bond sp2. This carbon all are single bonds sp3. And coming to this carbon. Carbon having double bond. This is sp2. This oxygen, what is the hybridization of this oxygen? It has a 2 sigma bonds. 2 sigma plus. How many free lone pairs are there? These 2 lone pairs, these lone pair of electrons involves in resonance. When this lone pair of electrons involves in resonance, how many free lone pairs you can see? 2 pairs are there, 2 lone pairs. among these two loan pay, one loan pay involves in residence, one free loan pay is there. So I can write one free loan pay. I am not taking the two loan pay because one is involves in residence, one is free. So one loan pay plus two sigma. This is one sigma. This is one sigma. So together three. This is what SP. And what about the CH3? Yes. Okay. So this way we can find out the hybridization of the even the hetero atoms like the nitrogen, oxygen, any atom. We can find the hybridization based on simple point. So we have to understand that to find out the hybridization, sigma bonds plus free lone pair. Sigma bonds plus free lone pair together will decide the hybridization in organic compounds of hetero atoms. Okay. Even for carbon also we can apply the same rule. But we as a simple trick we are finding the carbon having single bonds sp3, double bonds sp2, triple bond sp, like that we are discussing. Okay. Now we'll see some examples. Hybridizations we cannot eliminate as a simple topic. So many questions are asking in the JE examinations and NEET also. I'll write two examples, two problems. This is NEET 2016. Okay. Hybridization of NO2 plus NO3 minus NH4 plus respectively. You see, so question I'm asking completely. The question is the hybridization of the NO2 plus NO3 minus NH4 plus respectively. So what is the hybridization of NO2 plus? I told you the formula H is equal to V plus M minus C plus A by 2. So V is what? 5 plus 0, charge on cation is 1, anion 0 by 2 is equal to 2, SP hybridization. And NO3 plus H is equal to 5 plus 0 minus 0, charge on anion is 1, because minus 1 you is 1, is equal to 3, it is SP2. And NH4 plus is SP3. We can find out the same thing. So what is the hybridization? SP, SP2, SP3. This is the answer. So this way we can find out the answer easily in the computer examinations. See, hybridization or bond order, whatever it may be, can find out by taking a long period of time. But in the computer examination, we have to take the time management is very important. Okay. So this way, in JEE examination also, there are so many questions. Okay, we can practice the previous year questions mainly. We can practice so many questions based on this formula, so you can build your concept. Okay. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please share and comment. If any doubts are there, mention the comment box and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.